X-Men 3, The Last Stand, in a nutshell. The film starts off in a flashback, where Charles Xavier and Magneto go to meet Jean Grey, and tell her all about the mutants. Then she uses her powers to lift some cars up. 10 years later, because that's 20 years, a kid is picking his wings up, and his father finds out. It then cuts to a training war room in the present time, where a bunch of popular X-Men battle a Sentinel. But Wolverine says they're not strong enough, then goes flying into the Sentinel and kills it, ending the simulation. Storm gets upset at him. Scott is still crying after the last film, and sees Jean Grey in his mind. Bobby and Rogue have an argument about her powers. Cyclops then leaves all emo-like. At the Mutant Affairs building, Beast is reading, upside down, and enters a meeting about Magneto sightings. Also that they have captured Mystique. They then try to get answers out of her, and gets told about the mutant cure thingy. Back to Charles Xavier, teaching mutants, but stops to see the weather change, where Storm is upset, so Charles sees her, and then they meet Beast and Wolverine, and they all talk about Magneto and the mutant cure. Then, the Angel's father tells the whole world about the cure, and the place to get the cure, a big hint for later. Rogue says, "Cure me!" The Mutant Underground tried to form a group, and Magneto butts in with his bitch boy Pyro, and then recruits them for his evil army. Mystique is being transported in a prison van. Beast then visits the cure factory, and finds out the cure is a boy. Scott is driving around crying his eyes out, and goes to where the dam blew up in the last film, and he hears Jean's voice. He then blasts the wall all angry-like, which sends out a shockwave, and out pops Jean Grey. He then takes his glasses off, and Jean stops his eye blast. They then kiss, and Jean eats him. The professor hears this and sends out Wolverine and Storm. They land at the lake, where they find floating rocks and Cyclops' glasses. Also, they find Jean Grey's body, which they take back to the X-Mansion and explain all about the Phoenix, sort of. Elsewhere, mutants queue to get the cure, including Angel Man / Crybaby, but he chickens out and jumps out the window and flies away. Mystique is still being driven around when Magneto stops the truck and Mystique breaks out. She then tells Magneto that she knows about the cure. Then, Magneto hires new mutants to his cause. Mystique then gets shot by the cure and becomes normal and gets left behind. Wolverine then wakes Jean Grey up and they sleep together, but he regrets it when she goes too far. He then questions her about Scott, and then she goes crazy and leaves the X-Mansion. Magneto gets told about the power Jean sent off and plans to get her. Storm finds Wolverine and he tells the others that she killed Scott. So we go back to Jean's old house from the flashback, where we meet Magneto and his cronies. They all go inside except for Wolverine and Storm, and they meet Jean Grey, / now a Phoenix. Charles tries to talk to her, but Magneto bucks in. Wolverine and Storm fight Magneto's cronies. Jean Grey then makes the professor disappear into thin air. Magneto then takes her with him. So back at the X-Mansion, they mourn Charles Xavier. Bobby and Kitty Pryde talk and go ice skating, while Rogue watches and then leaves to get the cure. Magneto and his army camp out in the woods, while the X-Men group up with Angel Boy. Bobby then finds out Rogue has gone. Wolverine then has visions of Jean Grey and goes after her. Bobby goes out looking for Rogue and meets Pyro. Pyro then attacks a building for his master, Magneto, who tells the world about his plans. The president sends out his men / army and gives them all plastic guns with a cure in them. Rogue still queues up. Wolverine then gets attacked by a mutant in the woods. He knocks him down and more come after Wolverine, who fires more, killing a bunch of them. He then sparks Magneto and Jean Grey, so he speaks to Jane, but Magneto stops him. Then Magneto then throws him away. Raven, now a depowered Mystique, tells the government everything. The army then moves in on Magneto's camping party. There they move in, but it turns out to be only one mutant. Magneto heads to the cure manufacturer place. Wolverine then recruits the X-Men to go after Jean. They then use the X-Jet thingy and head out. Magneto then moves the Golden Gate Bridge to the mutant cure manufacturing place and walks straight in and starts attacking the place. But the army showers them in cures, turning them all normal, till a mutant stops them all. His mutants then charge again, and the X-Men arrive one by one, and the two fight. Juggernaut gets sent after the boy, so Kitty tries to stop him. She finds him first, but her powers stop, and Juggernaut knocks himself out. Angel then catches his dad because two mutants threw him off a roof. Storm kills a woman, and Magneto starts throwing cars at the place. Bobby then goes after Pyro and the two start fighting, until Bobby knocks him out cold. Wolverine goes towards Magneto but gets stopped mid-air, and then Beast stabs him with the cure. But Jean Grey gets mad at humans and kills a whole bunch of them, and destroys some buildings. Kitty gets out with the cure kid. Magneto realizes his mistake and runs away, while Wolverine runs towards Jean and stabs her in the chest with both hands / claws, killing her. The X-Men mourn all their losses, while Bobby talks to Rogue, who's now powerless. The students all return back to the X-Mansion. Beast gets a promotion, while Magneto just plays chess, but he still has his power. Or does he? The end.